I like my community. I've lived there for 10 years, and I'm quite pleased with my alderman. She really responds to all of our needs.
She needs to keep kids in safe programs, out of school programs, so they'll be safe from the streets and clean up the streets and fix these potholes and everything.
I would like for my alderman to provide jobs in my community, because it seems like a lot of people are unemployed.
I've been recently researching how to start a city club, a block club for this city, and surprisingly, there's no block clubs in my whole ward. I would like to see more participation of the actual community than him just being the boss of our ward without us not having to say so much.
There should be a lot more stores in the area, a lot more accessible areas for handicapped and blind. There should be some lights, some sounds for the blind people.
They can improve on the blue light, the crime blue light that's in the area, as far as because it takes the value down of the property by the blue lights being real broadcasted in the street.
We thank the McCormick Foundation and the Fields Foundation for their contributions and support, providing a voice and concern for Chicago students through media. Let's get into this. People in school right now, Kennedy King College students, they want safer streets, they want jobs, they want block clubs. They really don't like these blue light cameras, even though they are effective, and they don't want their aldermen to be bosses. JoAnn Thompson, help me out. Out of those statements that you just heard, what really piqued your interest?
Well, first of all, I'm not the boss of anyone, and we are doing very well. I built a 99-unit SRO. It was built to help the homeless. We also have a medical campus being built at 52nd and Ashland. We have on 60th and Halsted, we'll have a veterans housing for homeless veteran women with an emphasis on women. It'll be a studio and four-bedroom apartments.
Okay, so, good. So you just answered the next question I was going to ask. You know, what have you done for your ward lately? And I want to talk about empirical, sustainable, measurable things. Let me come to Alderman Lyle. Two, three things, sustainable, measurable. What have you done for your ward?
We have a mentor program that my foundation got funded for. We ran a six-ward leadership academy for 50 young people this past summer at Robeson High School. It was free. And we've put mentors into four elementary schools and Robeson High School for the entire school year. We have just put new lighting from 71st to 75th Street in the alleys from State to Cottage Grove, because people were concerned about crime, darkness, so we upgraded all the lighting. We've got, my ward is one of the few wards on the an African American community that between 2002 and 2008 created jobs. We had a 9.1% increase in the number of jobs, so we've been fighting to bring jobs in business by business by business. So we've built housing, we've improved our schools, we've been working.
Give me three bullet points, Willie B. Cochran.
We've introduced urban agriculture. We've worked with Kennedy King to bring a center for working families that will be in this institution that will reach out to families, and not only families that are challenged, families that are earning money to support their efforts to get a better education. We've put in new youth programs, track and field. I've started out with one track and field program. Now it is 26 clubs across the city that we've created for our youth to be engaged to look at healthy initiatives. We've built over 400 new units of housing in the 20th Ward, and all of these things take time. We've introduced a new grocery store in Washington Park, which is now, for the last 50 years, no new grocery store has been in Washington Park, and we've made 400 people employed from efforts in the 20th Ward.
Okay, look, I've heard some good things here. It sounds like the three of you are trying to keep your job and that you're doing the right thing. Let me see if I can sneak one more phone call here. Tony, make it quick. You're on off 63rd. Tony, thank you for calling. What's your comment?
Hey, how you guys doing this evening?
All right.
This is Anthony Lindsay. I actually work closely with you guys. I just wanted to give a plug to all three of you guys. I think you're doing a wonderful job.
Thank you.
Those that's complaining, I think they need to actually log on. Go to their website. They have ward night, they have community meetings, have outreach events. They have open door policy, all three of these guys. And I know them personally. I work with them. They always address the issues of their constituents. And like I said, they have an open door policy. So for those that are complaining, they just don't know. They haven't read.
Tony, thanks for the call. Wow, big compliment.
Well, he's right. The three of you. I have seen over 4,000 people in my open ward nights over the last 3.5 years with no appointment. You walk in and see me, and we talk about your issues. And those 4,000 just didn't come from the 20th ward.
We didn't get to talk about charter schools. I do want to ask this quick, though. Magnet schools, charter schools, pro or con, Alderman Thompson?
For magnet schools, I'd say sort of pro.
Pro, Willie Cochran.
Quality education.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Regina Lyle.
I believe we need to improve and make every neighborhood school a magnet school.
Mm, interesting. I like that. That's sweet.
Right. We should.
Yeah. Yeah. You know what? I want to thank you all for being on. You know, we never have enough time. Voting is fundamental. I hope your constituents get out and vote for you or the other candidate. We'll have the challengers on next week. Thanks to my guests, Verdrina Lyle, Willie Cochran, and JoAnn Thompson. As we close, please think about how we can help Rasul Rocky Clark, the Eisenhower High School football player who became paralyzed from the neck down. He received a note from his medical insurance company stating that the $5 million limit on his insurance has run out. We have to help Rocky. Congratulations to Destiny Morris from Englewood Community Academy for her award-winning essay. That's Off 63rd for this evening. We appreciate you. Hey, I need you to stay positive. Keep your head up and always be encouraged.